So I've got some stuff for, I've got an underactive thyroid, so I'm getting that, taking herbs for that. Go away.
His family helped an awful lot, but in the end it really was down to him. There was a lot of outside influences, you know, the press and, you know, his manager and, you know, there was everybody wanted to see him get better. As far as I could see, except the press, you know, they were the ones that were trying to, you know, waiting for him to drop off, you know, and, you know, he had a lot of strength and he got through it.
And you've been living together for how long?
I think it's about 7 years now. But I did have my own flat about 3 of those years where I used to go to whenever we'd, you know, usual couples arguments. You know. I'd pop down there and he'd stay up here, you know, it was just down the road, Hampstead.
Look at me and say I'm a victim of desire, a hypocrite and every bit the ordinary liar. The scars of my deceit I will take to my grave. I know I've told you many times this is the wrong way to be.
As I've got older, I've been trying to find some space for myself and be able to put your foot down and say, look, I can't do that. I'm not flying all the way across the world and doing a concert. And of course, people think you're being difficult, but actually, at the end of the day, you do have to end up protecting yourself because there isn't anybody else who's going to do it for you. It's like trying to connect being artistic and creative with making money. And the two things are just so separate.
Attract the lonely and the lost, attract the free. The moves are never easy, but there's plenty of love for sale. You are frightened by rejection, you're so scared to be alone. You act like you're so free, but you're just waiting by the phone. Doesn't happen every day.
Combine fashion and cooking. I never used to be able to cook anything. You know, I just basically cooked for myself. Michael rarely eats in this house, you know. I don't allow any meat or animal products in the house. So, you know, I try to keep this house like karma free, because it's like, you know, you can't be a vegetarian and have meat and animal products used in your cooking. You know what I mean? You can't have like a lump of, you know, it just doesn't work.
Good to have you in New York again.
Yeah.
Yeah, Julie.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you? Good to see you.
I got a camera.
Oh, okay.
Good.
My lunch is here?
Yep.
Okay. Okay. Thanks.
Good timing, huh?
Does you want, Tony, are you hungry?
No.
You want some vegetables?
No, I'm going to have lunch later. It's fine.
You sure?
Yeah.
Got some vegetables?
No, definitely not.
No?
Okay.
Huh?
I don't know what this meeting's about. Well, I'll tell you what the meeting's about, right? We have got with us a compilation album.
Great.
Right? Which you've got here. George, have you got any tapes or not?
No.
Okay, this is George and Culture Club, right? There are two. There's a that and a...
There's going to be an EP, which has got some remixes, Generations of Love, and a track called Love Hurts, which is on the last album, which you probably haven't even heard.
Right.
And then there's probably going to be a new track, which will go with it. In England, that's what we're doing, putting out the EP with the album.
So, this is super.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
I love this.
Yeah.
Why don't we get this out for Christmas?
Well, that's what we're doing in England. They're
great.
TV advertising it.
You got that here?
Yep. And see if Francis would like to come in.
This is great.
So I had a meeting with Tony, I had a meeting with the video jukebox. The box?
Yeah, yeah, right.
The crying game is still one of the most requested videos on the box.
That's wonderful.
So we could put this out possibly for Christmas, Francis.
Look at the songs.
And since the crying game, the alternative radio, everybody's putting all these songs back in.
Right.
Which is great.
No, the old songs.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know that.
It's fantastic.
great time.
Good night.
I go to those meetings, it makes me really, really nervous. I feel like I'm going to throw up.
Why?
I don't know, it's like a bit like being on jukebox jury. It's like all these people, like the music starts to sound weird, you know, like it doesn't sound as good as it did when you made it. You know, everything sort of sounds like it's wrong and awkward, and you feel like, you know, like it's not good. You just really sort of start to question your talent and your, you know what I mean? It's just so weird.
I like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
How would that be for Christmas?
That'd be great.
So.
Desert Josh and Mia, they put Kankan in their hair. At the Westerners they stare, hurry, hurry, hurry. Paint a T-lock on your brow, open like a lotus flower. It's time to check your karma now. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Bow down, mister. Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. Bow down, mister. We say right.
I think that in essence, you know, all the people that are drawn to Krishna consciousness are drawn to the kind of community and the sort of safety of Krishna consciousness. It's like when you look around you in the world and you see all the suffering and all the pain and all the confusion, it does make things very simple. In a way, so does Christianity, so does a lot of religions.
What about George and religion now?
Well, of course, I mean, it's changed two or three times. I just keep telling him he's a Catholic. He tells, he says, well, I didn't ask to be a Catholic. I've asked him, you know, spoke about it to him, and he finds them that Krishna is very calm. And I think that's the fact that they're not warlike or, do you know what I mean? Because he's definitely calming down, I think, a lot. Like, he's learning not to shout and holler so much.
When we were in Italy, I was really shouting because I didn't want to go out to eat at the Krishna temple. And because we'd already eaten there the day before. And, you know, it was just like too many religions for me to cope with, because it was like we went to the Vatican as well in the same day as going to eat at the Krishna's. And it was just like, I was like, what the hell is going on? I just could not cope with it. And George was at the front of the Vatican, like, making me pray. He was like, say a prayer, say a prayer. I was like, you know, so I was just like, had to get out of there.
One of the first things that I liked about the devotees was the way they looked. And when I was about 17, I remember seeing them and thinking, wow, they look brilliant, you know, and beautiful. I mean, I love men with shaved heads. And, you know, I like that innocence. I mean, I'm very attracted to innocence. One of the most attracting qualities, I think, in anyone is vulnerability, which I kind of have, but I hide it well. And I think that, you know, I just love that. I think it's really attractive. There have been some couple of swamis, which are the kind of higher up priests, who have kind of taken me to task about my sexuality, you know.
One of the swamis, who I won't name, said to me, you know, that it was harder for homosexuals to enter the gates of heaven. And I just said, yeah, especially if you lock them.
You're the first in line.
Oh, no, that's real. From the house of Chanel.
I've always said that, like, being gay was like a real saving grace for me, because I think if I wasn't gay, I would probably end up really, really establishment.
Quite apart from getting the makeup right.
What do I see? My own sad reflection staring back at me as a lyric to a song. It's a weird thing, you know, because I am a big Ed and I do love myself, but then there's a part of me that just hates myself too. I've got much better. I mean, part of the whole spiritual thing, part of the whole religious thing has really helped me to just lighten up, to realise that it's not important. If people don't like me, I mean, I always said when I was younger, if you don't like me for what I am, then shove off. But of course it wasn't really true.
Weakness is my child, kicking in the womb, crying all the way from the cradle to the tomb. See your mother's tears roll down from her sad eyes, wishing you could change her life. Talk about my destiny, I don't understand. Feel it is too obvious for every angry man. All things wise, hidden behind my eyes, all things wise, all things wise. Hidden behind your eyes, all things wise.
I'm not going to do any more till you all tell me you love me.
In Omnibus next week, the mystery of who killed Tchaikovsky. Cholera was the official cause of the composer's death, but new evidence suggests it may have been suicide. Next Tuesday at 10:20.
Polska, a celebration of arts and culture. The Polish season on BBC Radio 3.
Recent brain research is one of the topics in tonight's Late Show Science Special on BBC 2 now. Here on BBC 1, a few minutes later than scheduled, our movie classic. David Niven gets an unexpected new lease of life after bailing out of his plane, a matter of life and death.